by Wilkes. Nice catch, and he's in for the score. And quickly, New York on top, 1-0.
It's a good sign for it looked like Heyman put that up. Wilkes is injured, so that shouldn't be Wilkes, but it was number four, unless he snuck onto the field. Wilkes is still on the sideline, so we'll have to figure out who that is. But beautiful little put there. Oh, no problem with the win there, Don.
I'm only good as the numbers they show me.
Yeah, no, I'm with you. I do believe that Dan Heyman did put that disc up, and if that's a great sign for New York. If he gets on fire, he's a guy that if he wants, he's got a strong will to make things happen.
Is this the future, you think, for New York? The quick strike going way downfield, or was that something just given to him by the spinner defense here the first time?
I want to say that was just kind of there. You know, I mean, maybe that was a play they might have set up. Hard to say. We'll have to see. They do it again.
So we'll have the pull from left to right here, and spinners will get their first opportunity with the disc in hand.
Anderson with the pull.
It might have been affected by the wind a little short to about the football 30-yard line. Dimensions of the field are interesting, too. A little bit bigger than what these guys might be used to playing on here as we get a little quick slap there, and the disc awarded on the penalty right back to the spinners. Game in which you can't be all that physical. Arnett, a fine player for the spinners a year ago, had a quick touch.
That was an unfortunate turnover early in the game, a short field for New York to work with.
So New York trying to jump out on top quickly here, 2-0 in the opening quarter. They play 10-minute quarters. And that's a great layout catch out there in the left side. That was Baker with the catch.
There's Littauer, Ross Littauer from Philadelphia, able to get into Joe Smash Anderson for the second goal from New York, taking an early 2-0 lead. Hey, that was a nice little break mark throw, Don, you saw from Corey Lee, number 11. He's won nationals twice in the mixed division and the USAU division for a team out in the West Coast, Blackbird, and this will be his first pro experience, and looks like he fits in pretty well.
So New York quickly on top, 2-0. We've only played a minute seven. So the spinners working from behind. A lot of display left, however, in the opening quarter of this exhibition game.
Don, Billy and the spinners were telling me they were going to open up their lines, especially in this first half. So we saw what would be a pretty routine play turn into a turnover on short field. And, you know, that might be because we're seeing some new players out there and he's giving some people a shot.
That was a good strong pull with the wind at the back of New York, and now the spinners trying to work a bit into that wind.
Looks like a zone. No, I take it back.
Spinners to the near side here.
Himalayan Mehta with the disc.
Yep. You have 10 seconds to hold on to that disc before you make that decision.
Is that Furf? Fafari with the disc. Finds Harrison. That's going to be Trigube, yep.
Trigube, a fine player, very strong player. Good play downfield in for the point, so they score. That was Panner, I believe, on the receiving end. As he got open, and it's now 2-1. So,
well, it's nice to have that lefty, you know, on that side of the field. Furf broke the mark, got it over to him, and Harrison had an easy lefty backhand. Panner, I believe, also is another player who is out for today, so we'll have to find out who that is.
Okay.
Preseason action here. We're going to see, people getting used to all the positions on the field, off the field, playing in the stadium. The spinners are used to this, but New York, for sure, this is a new experience. A lot of us that have played Ultimate for years and years and years have, at times, played on football fields. I know at college nationals they did a similar sort of circumstance, but the field is gorgeous. It's just a beautiful field. The turf is awesome. Great, great place to play.
So New York to work from their own end zone to try to get things moving upfield, leading by the score of 2-1 here in the opening quarter. Spinners look like they might be going man-to-man defensively right now.
Avergan, old veteran, throws it away.
So the spinners with a chance on the turnover.
Sean Murray
not
with
the score.
D.
Can't wait for them to change the color of those numbers on the back of those jerseys. We'll certainly, a little physical play right there, and that will bring a whistle. Infraction 5 yards further downfield for the Spinners. See if they can dump it off here into the end zone for a point. Good breakout in the right. Might have been Casey. And it's in for the score. We're tied at 2, so the Spinners come back quickly. At one point they were down 2-0.
I think Nick Perfico made the D on that. You say Nick, right? Yeah, Nick. Good job from Nick.
We're tied at 2, so the Spinners.
So that'll tie things up at 2. They'll move the pace along here a little bit. Flag now still on the flagpole down to the wire right by the scoreboard.
You know, Rumble was telling me that they wanted to use the width of the field. They hadn't really played on a field this wide before. And I think what you saw here is that I think Jody thought he had more space on the sideline to kind of get that throw in, and he kind of threw, you know, almost a lazy throw to the sideline, whereas the Spinners D was able to go side to side very well and get in front of that for the block.
It's a good, strong pull, and New York with a chance to hurry it up a little bit and move it down the field. Lucas Murphy plays it out to the near side. Herman. Working that sideline effectively. That's Alcott. Some tight defense played on him right there by Telasco.
That's a nice cover.
New York pressing that dish downfield quickly.
He had him. Let's see if Heyman's going to find somebody here. Heyman's wearing Chris Mazur's jersey. I don't think Mazur's out here, though.
Okay. That's totally going to confuse me.
That's right. It's a goal.
That's right. Into the corner. So New York able to put some points up on the board. 3-2 you score.
Cheer for Lionel, who's nursing an injury. Lionel Winiger for New York. Yeah, that's Dan wearing Chris Mazur's jersey. I don't know where Mazur is. Mazur is an excellent player in his own right. Hopefully we'll see him out here.
You might expect this in an exhibition game, the names and the numbers that get flip-flopped around and alike. So
we apologize, folks.
Absolutely.
We'll try to get that sorted out for you.
I don't think that's going to happen. As long as the coaches know who's performing well out there, right?
Correct. Absolutely.
New York on the turnover. Trying to work quickly here in some transition.
Let's see what their D-line can do. They scored once already. There's Milo Snyder, a young up-and-coming player for the New York area, who's very fantastic, very fast.
That's Corey Lee now.
That's Corey again, yeah. Gets it to Ross, used to play for Philly area teams.
That was a nice catch by Ross. He was well covered.
Looks like we got a penalty. Spot foul coming back 5 yards and checked back in. Swung it back to Corey. Corey looking for Snyder. A break mark, risky. Woo.
Nice D.
Block from Mike Zargo.
Absolutely.
Mike out there, isn't it?
The Spinners. Trailing by a point, 3-2.
Oh.
That got away.
That's a little effect of the wind, Don. He's,
absolutely.
You got an interesting angle there. It's 45 degrees, but he got popped up a little bit in the air and just kind of floated over the head of two receivers that were open in the area. Yeah, you got it. Thank you. Throw to space. Is it up? It is not. Turnover for New York.
Yeah, Cox with a diving effort on that one, and Spinners will regain control. Spinners in the white, the Rumble of New York in the green.
Whoa, nice catch there.
Absolutely.
Milo coming in hard and fast here. That's Firth again, number 8. Harrison again with the disc. Yeah, Harrison. Tree Goob with the disc. Spot foul, 5 yards. This is what these contact fouls are, a 5-yard penalty, advance either, or move back. And the swing gets them the quick goal. I don't know if New York was ready for that. When that penalty happened, you saw they had an easy, quick score on the fourth side, and I don't think New York really adapted, because once a penalty happens, it's marked off right away, 5 yards, advance or move back, and play still continues. Everyone else on the field is allowed to move around except for the players involved in the foul. And I think you saw an example here of New York learning it right now, like, okay, guys, don't forget, you self the guard your man after a call like that.
So the Spinners tie it back up at 3, 4:27 remaining here in the first quarter. Not a bad crowd on hand for this exhibition game, too.
Got a lot of folks out here from New York and from Philadelphia and from New Jersey, for sure.
Here comes the pull from left to right.
And just in case you're not seeing it on the screen, folks, the crowd is on the camera side of the field in the large stands where we are.
So the rumble.
There's Heyman again, and I believe Jody Ivergan is wearing Lucas Murphy's, because Murphy isn't here either.
It could be Faust controlling, right?
Yeah, that's Faust.
All right. Faust with a very clever break after that throw, got in position for the return pass and helped the Ramble, or the Rumble, move that disc upfield here. Another infraction.
Gets it into Heyman. Let's see if Heyman can get his third score on the board.
Disc is in.
Thrown two. Jody. To Heyman, he should get this. There it is.
Yes!
Shoots
yes!
it in. Three goals for Dan Heyman out of the four for Rumble.
Hey, that last D line, you're on.
Hey, Joe. He certainly has been effective here in the opening quarter of play.
What's up, Van Lang? Ah, Nalavalde. Yeah, that's Jody. Yeah, once you get that space, he's using that sideline very well there. Heyman able to punch that in, and Valavalde to get in just to get enough space there.
Hey, bring it in on me.
Hey, bring it in by the bench.
Grab it in some water first.
Bench.
Yeah, sit on the bench.
So we're going to find out who's wearing Wilkes jersey. Worry about that in a bit. Let's see. Don, how much of these players do you recognize from last year's Spinners?
Well, by looking at the roster, lot of them.
Mm-hmm. For the numbers in the back,
that's right. That's right. With a change in numbers here today for this exhibition game.
Pull goes out of bounds. It'll be centered.
The Bayer brothers, David and Michael.
Mm-hmm.
A couple of guys I certainly remember. Arthur Shull.
Yeah. Let's go, Baker. Billy was telling me Art Shull's a farmer, and I said, that's a unique term. What is he? He really works hard out there. He says, no, he's actually a farmer. He gets up early, milks the cows. I look forward to seeing.
Of course, Trey Katzenbach
over there. Rob Baker gets the D for, this is Ross Littauer with the disc. Swings it. Back to Corey Lee's making some, cursed him. Nice catch.
Good support play right there by, is that Baker or is that somebody else?
There's two Bakers on the field right now. Yep. Let's see what Littauer can do. Oh, he wants that up the line? No. He's going to have to make a play here. Puts up a risky hammer, but it's caught. It's a goal. It's close to a goal. Not called in. Snyder with the hammer.
Nice gritty play.
Look at that. Milo finds an open man on the back of the end zone with a little bit of a bladey hammer. Beautiful put.
Listed as Rob Baker on the receiving end there.
We'll go with that.
So good work.
And I like that Milo's taking that. He's known as a D guy from what I know him as, and I love to see him make that play, make that throw. The count wasn't that high. He didn't have to do that. Man was open. He wasn't distracted by that blue streak of the end zone for the football program here, and he found his man and a beautiful, beautiful, look at that, wide open, nice shot. off the turnover, and Rumble takes a 5-3 advantage.
Got their two-goal lead back, two-point lead back again. They started the game with a 2-0 run. That win certainly affecting play here a bit today.
Faust with the pool, lays it in. A little bit short, but not too bad. Zargum with the advancement. Trigube.
Trigube seems to always be around the disc, gets to that open space, and kind of quarterbacking things right now.
Absolutely. Zargum, a little high. D isn't able to get there, however. Back to Zargum.
Spinners with an effective bit of play downfield in for the score to make it 5-4 in that far side.
Jonathan Casey.
Casey, very talented player. Remember Casey from a year ago?
Yeah. Zargum is another player, Don, who's wearing Stephen Thor's jersey number here. And that is Michael Zargum. I believe we'll see on this. And I believe, you know, one of the main players that we all know and we've all seen in the sport for years now, Trey, I don't think he's out here today. This is a preseason game, and he might not necessarily be needed. He'll be a factor as the season progresses for sure. Another player to note, Jonah Wish, number 38 there. Billy was telling me he's an 18-year-old freshman going into the University of Pittsburgh this year, the defending national champions in college, and he'll be seeing some time today. So this is an 18-year-old playing with some veterans of the game on here. Beautiful pull. See that pull down.
Very strong. The Rumble now have to really move that ball, that disc downfield. Long way to go.
I'm not seeing. Okay. They're running a host stack, and Philly's right in. They're just eating the host stack up. They've only been scoring effectively, really, on D. That was too easy.
Absolutely.
For Philadelphia.
So their defense leading to a point, and right back into it again, tied at 5 with 1:47 left.
Sean Murray with the score. Leon, a long-time Philadelphia guy, coaches a lot of youth ultimate. Leon Chu with the D there, kind of reading that the action underneath on the host stack that the Rumble is attempting. It looked more like a blob stack, Don. I didn't really see them get into much of a formation. I think they're still really trying to find their offensive rhythm. Is pretty clear. They're effective enough on D.
Just want to mention LT Photos is the official photography partner of Major League Ultimum. LT Photos features an elite group of ultimate photographers across the United States and Canada who are passionate about the sport of ultimate. They're also available to cover your ultimate tournament and capture incredible photo memories for participants and the fans out there. Check them out at www.ultiphotos.com and check out their complete MLU game coverage at MLUimages.com.
Well, Avrigan didn't get that big forehand hook to really seal in there. Got two defenders kind of red with that, hung up in the air with the wind a little bit. Turnover for Rumble. See if Philly can capitalize to take an advantage. They have a minute 17 left on the clock here, so they'll be looking. They got enough time easy to put this in without too much of a rush.
Yeah, that's one of the big differences playing at this level now, with the time clock also being a factor. It puts a little pressure on you to try to beat that clock and put up some points. And
yeah. If New York is smart, they'll play, you know, try to keep them from jacking it.
Let's see if they can
hold them for the half. Okay, now it's going to be too difficult. I think at this point, a strategy might be to let them score.
Easy. We're easy.
Get as much time on the clock as you can. Whoa. Okay, let's see if there's a call here. I don't know. Heyman got up there to try to make a D. Looks like the call from referee Harrington on Heyman. It's going to be a foul on Rumble, is my guess. And a goal. tough one. I think Heyman made a play there, and he got just too much body. Let's see here. We'll get the replay. Wow, they're still trying to figure it out. Yeah, that's pretty close there. Heyman was clearly behind them. I don't know what the discussion is, Don. Can you tell what they're talking about? The refs are trying to decide whether it's a flagrant foul, maybe?
Yeah. It was a pretty good collision.
Okay, they're just awarding the disc at the goal line, so it's a contact foul.
And they complete for the point.
All right, so Nick Heron out there, he's going to be their main guy with throw there. He's going to be all over the field as the season goes. He's the one to watch for the season. This is what Coach Maroon was telling me, and was a stat machine last year and quarterback in the team.
Yeah, he was terrific on the receiving as we show. Got some great height. He uses that to his advantage. So the Spinners now leading 6-5 in this exhibition game. With a timeout down on the field. Just want to mention Friction Gloves are the official glove provider of the MLU. These all-weather gloves are specially designed for ultimate players, combining the tackiness of receiver gloves with a rubberized grip for better catches and throws. Look for the Friction Gloves Catch of the Week throughout the season and get an official MLU pair for yourself soon from the MLU shop. Visit frictiongloves.com to learn more. You wear those gloves?
I haven't. I would like to try them out and see what's up with them. But I want to know if the disc sails up here into the booth and I make the Scott, can I get Catch of the Week on that?
Only if you have the gloves on.
What?
You got to wear the gloves.
No, it doesn't say that. I didn't read that in the promo. I'm going to have to talk to the people at Friction about that.
Right, exactly.
One of these fans is probably going to win right now.
Yeah,
I haven't seen
absolutely.
A lot of nothing fantastic yet.
Some T-shirts being thrown up into the crowd by the members of the MLU, and that's what you'll get when you head on out to take in one of these games in person, a chance to catch a free T-shirt and enjoy all the excitement of MLU play.
Don, I want to know who the kid wearing Trey's shirt is out there. there's a non-Trey Katzenbach wearing a Katzenbach shirt on the line for the Spinners right now. And it's funny, if you know Trey, who's 6'2" and, you know, heavily built and vocal and a big man on the field, and then you see a totally different person occupy his shirt.
23 seconds remaining here in the opening quarter. Coming out of the timeout, Spinners have the lead at 6-5.
Smart timeout call by Rumble, Don. I like it because they're going to have to make a play in 23 seconds. So they're, you know, they're, why not call that timeout and design something? And let's see if their design works.
We're going to have to pick the disc up off the carpet to get it going.
Averaging to Jake Herman. Jake Herman's a longtime Philadelphia player. He should know these guys. The zone is effective right now. This is a zone defense from Philly to prevent this 23-second score. They got 10 seconds now. Here's the point where someone's got a jacket. Do they recognize it? 5 seconds. Is he going to put it? There's the put. Now, is it enough air underneath? D'd up. Wow, it was a good look. Good opportunity. I like the shot. Unfortunate to not come down with that, but great D by Philadelphia.
Yeah, Shell coming up with the fine defensive play. All right, we'll take a break. We're through one quarter of play, and the Philadelphia Spinners, they have the lead by the score of 6-5. We'll be back with more right after this. We'll be right back. All right, welcome right back here. Nice to be with you all as we're broadcasting live from the John Bauer Memorial Stadium on the campus of Randolph High School here in Randolph, New Jersey. Exhibition encounter, and a pretty good one here between the Philadelphia Spinners and the New York Rumble, as these two teams will be competing in the upcoming regular season of the MLU, which starts in just a couple of weeks, Tony, and very athletically played first quarter of play, and the Spinners had to battle back from a couple of two-point deficits to get the lead through one quarter.
Yeah. Yeah, Rumble had them up by two twice. Yeah, a lot of game to go. But playing against a the rotating lines of the Spinners, I think Rumble will have a little bit more of an advantage there. However, I think their lack of experience with the field and sort of the pace of this game has cost them a bit.
And obviously playing not too many games as a cohesive unit as of yet certainly makes a big difference, I think, with timing and just confidence in what your teammate's going to do out there. And you know, as I think it was Mazur who had mentioned on one of the videos on the MLU website, the you know, with the bigger field, you don't hear the sideline talk chatter, which used to be a big help. So you have to really rely on the support system of your teammates in a different way of communicating, especially defensively.
Lonely out there, for sure. It's a big difference. Oh, he's looking deep. Looks like Rumble's trying out a zone here almost.
Spinner's trying to break it quickly. Great floater upfield and caught on the run for the point.
Hey, like, way to recognize from Philadelphia there. Rumble looked a little bit off guard. You see DQ giving a handshake now to the Rumble player, saying, hey, nice try out there. Don't think that zone was effective. Let's see who put that in. Looks like Salasco. Well, and makes an easy catch. It says 82, but that's not Salasco. Who caught that?
Yeah, he did.
Okay.
So it was Salasco.
Salasco with the catch, and we're thinking our 18-year-old Jonah Wish with the throw.
So the Spinners with their first two-point lead here today. High majestic pull. Look at that. The floating on down to the back.
That is a perfect pull. Plenty of time to set up your defense. Here's the Hostack again from Rumble. They send a man, but there's no chance. It's too much distance still. Herman. Oh, there's a nice rip from Heyman. Let's see if that hangs it up a little bit, but if you trust his receiver.
Ooh. Oh, boy, still in the way.
Look at that. Great. Just pulls it out of the air.
That was terrific.
These order numbers in order. Okay, here's a big rep. Let's see. This could be a D. Nope. Hey, had just enough space over it. What a nice touch from the Spinners. Let's see if they can work it in now. Off the Baker. This is against the Rumble O line, so they should find opening spaces. Bingo.
Well, they're starting to show some dominance right now, the way they're playing out there. Looking well coordinated.
You know, that's a big risk, high reward from Heyman to stroke that, the forehand that led to the D. It was a great D. On the other hand, he's thrown to a covered receiver. So you wonder if they're starting to feel a little pressure, the O-line here, to score.
8-5, Spinners on top after the point recorded. 8:54 remaining till halftime. Just want to mention before the poll to keep up on all the news and events from around the league, like the MLU on Facebook or at facebook.com/MLUltimate, and follow the league at twitter.com/MLUultimate. Great way to stay in touch with all the news around the league, and I certainly encourage you to go into that website too. It's spectacular. All kinds of information and video features up online.
Surprised they got Harrison off of the disc golf course for MLU here. Love Harrison, actually. He's a good disc golf player, too. Oh, whoa. Ooh. That was close.
What a challenge.
No, Jody picks it up right away. He's not even going to sweat this one. See if the refs have something to say, however. He's going to call a contact foul, looks like, on Philadelphia. Jay's going to move up five, restart it, swing it back over. Milo switch from the D-line to the O-line. Moves up to Heyman. Heyman, now they're going to try to work it here in the Valavati. Jody's going deep. That's not the look they want. Back to Milo, but there's a call.
Hey, guys, who's poached? Who is poached?
Robbie, you're too deep.
All right, let's see if... I think they're going to be more conservative on this point, Don. That's Jody Ivor again wearing Lucas Murphy's shirt. Popped it up. Nice read. Faust. Nice put there to Valavetti. That's like a goal.
How about Faust using that great body control to come down with that pass and then the presence of mind to find his teammate for the point.
Hey, he's got height too. He's one of the taller players on the Rumble. We got Joe Smash. He's going to see most of the D line. And so Faust is kind of they're relying on him on the height on the O line there. Especially with Webster McBride out. McBride is on this roster. If you know Webster, he's listed as 6'3 here. He's probably around 6'4, I want to say, actually. He's a good presence on the height side for this Rumble team, and we'll see him later on in the season. Same with Trey Katzenbach on the spinners. We'll see him later on in the season. Here's Joe Smash. Down 8-6 for the Rumble. Spinners have a nice margin here in receiving the disc, and you got to get the sense that Rumble is going to have to make some more plays after those goals, the leads that they gave up against an experienced team like this. It's going to just get stronger as the game progresses. They're going to need some points soon. This could be an opportunity.
Still a free disc up there. Possession to who?
Corey Lee from Rumble gets it over Art Schull, who is a little late to it, and they award it to Lee. Litauer to Snyder. Snyder up to Cox. I don't think that's Jonathan Cox. I don't think that's Waldo, actually, but maybe it is. Joe Smash. Smash to... Swings it to Corey. Corey's got Milo in the end zone. Nope. It's a little zony. See this little defense here? They little switch a little matchup zone. Ross is an experienced handler. Having him in the D-line is great. Is very smart for New York Rumble. Okay, so Ross with the disc here. Litauer looking in the end zone. He only needs 5 yards. Can he get it? Lee made the quick side cut. Lee's getting very active out here. Cox dumps it back to Litauer. Looks like there's a call. Yeah. And disc back in. What's he looking for? Milo makes a nice hot grab there. Way to get down low. Snyder sneaks it over. Cox looking for the score. Can't find. He laces it up. This is going to be tough. It's going to be on the line. It's a turnover. A little too much there. That's not his role. He's getting active there. But I like the disc in Ross Litauer or Milo Snyder's hands better at that point for throwing that goal shot. Or Corey Lee, for that matter. They got some good offensive handlers. Here's Schull with the disc. Salasco. This is a long point, Don. I wonder if they're getting... starting to feel a little bit tired with this length of this field here. A lot of open players for the spinners. Oof. Should be a goal.
Well, they've been accurate with their throws, too.
And there it is.
Wide open.
Firth gets the throw to Glazer. It's on a wish.
So the spinners take a 9-6 lead with 5:22 remaining here in the opening half. Support the Rumble and keep up with all the team news by liking them on Facebook, facebook.com, New York Rumble, and follow twitter.com, New York Rumble, to, keep in touch with the New York Rumble.
I like that head spike.
That was cool.
get your head back in the game with that one. You know, boosh, ready for it. 5 minutes left in the second quarter and the first half.
Spinners on top by three.
They really figured out these pulls very well.
Yeah, haven't they? Seems as though the wind has quieted down a little bit. It's not shaking the flag as it was earlier.
You're right. Yeah. Big Huck. I like how that's going. It's a little fast, though. Let's see if he's got room underneath it. Nope, too far.
There's Murphy on the Huck.
Yeah, and I think that's going to be Jody Avergan, and that's not Wilkes either. It could be Baker. Well, they're definitely not in the rhythm, the rumble, as they start this preseason. That's what the preseason is for.
Figure things out. What's going to work, what's not going to work.
Got 2 weeks here.
How many times a week are they practicing?
Well, I know they're practicing on Tuesdays right now. My guess is they'll open up another day. So, you know, 1 to 2 days, maybe a day of practice and a day of conditioning. Beautiful left-hand put. Let's see if that's got space. Easy D for Faust.
Nice read by Faust.
Yeah, he's got some speed. I tell you, for a guy with this height, he's a real athlete out there. I've tried to guard him before. I can't do it. It's really impossible. And if he wants to make a play, he can make a play almost any time he wants to. He's very talented. I think that's Bosco wearing number 7 down here. And here's Jody again wearing Lucas's shirt. Bosco gets it up. Gillis, Robbie Gillis finds, looks like Faust. Yeah. Bend to Dan Heyman. Heyman wants this because he got it. Nope. How many can he put another goal in? No, he's going to be patient. Smart gets it to Jody. Jody gets fouled. No call, so the refs didn't see it. Interesting. This is a different effect here, but he didn't let it affect him. He got right back into it, but normally in the ultimate that we've been used to playing, that would be a foul call and disc would stay there, but with the ref not seeing the play, it's a turnover. Let's see if Philly takes advantage.
Boy, they are trying to strike quickly here. Oh,
and they
nice
do.
Play.
Got hands on their knees for some of the Rumble players here.
Yeah, I was just going to mention that. 3:15 remaining till halftime, and now 10-6.
They might want to call a timeout here. They're starting to put their D players on the O-line. Already trying to DQ. Daniel Kawanta, the coach of Rumble here, is going to have to make some maneuvers. We see Billy Maroon out there on the field, coach of the Spinners. We're watching the replay now. It's a good score. You know, when you get a turnover like that, that's such a deflating turnover for the Rumble. Smart for the Spinners just to work it downfield, wait for the space to open up. It's going to take so much energy and effort from the Rumble to really find a space to get a block. That's all you need to do. You don't need to do much more.
Just want to mention, if you want to follow the Spinners, and why not, show your support for the Philadelphia Spinners. Get all the latest news by linking or liking to Facebook.com. Philadelphia Spinners. Yeah, you can have that favorite link, right? So Facebook.com/Philadelphia Spinners, and follow them on Twitter at Twitter.com/Philly Spinners to keep up to date.
Yeah, so they brought in some of the D-line players to the online. Obviously, we see Joe Smash Anderson out there. Snyder. Heyman still making plays and running hard out there with the disc right now. Heyman's looking downfield. Herman's open, but doesn't see him. Faust wants to rip it. Ooh, it gets macked at the line. Stays up in the air. Good break for New York. Valavadi hangs it for Joe. Can Joe get to this? Smash can't quite get there. Good D from Salasco, I believe. Tree Goob wants it. Tree Goob with it.
Hasn't had a touch in a while.
You're right, because the D-line's been on the field. Quick throw from Zargum, unfortunately, finds the turf for him. Rumble's trying to find out who's going to quarterback this out here. And they pick up Snyder for the disc. Ooh, could be a good play here. Just past the reach. Nice layout there from Dan Heyman. Just too far from Snyder. Far corner over there. Don's still a little hard for us to get to see over there.
Absolutely.
We need binoculars up here. Zargum with the disc back. Is he in? And Kalinske, the side referee over there, calls him out of bounds.
Still a heck of a catch over there.
Absolutely. Did as best he could to toe the line. Swung to Snyder. Finds Anderson, number 21. Joe is looking for Heyman. Oh, it's too late on that. Joe needed that, make that play. Zargum with a beautiful D to come through across the body of Heyman and really make that play.
Showed some great anticipation.
I think it was a delayed release from Joe. He had him a couple seconds earlier, Don, and he didn't make that throw. And by that time, Zargum was able to undercut the cut from Dan Heyman. We got a timeout at a minute 18 left in the first half. Smart timeout call here. You got to use him or lose him. Billy Maroon's out there on the field in the red cap, blue jacket, kind of get his folks together and see if they get a play.
All right, so with the timeout, we'll step aside for a brief moment. We'll be back with more of the MLU with the score. Spinners on top by the score of 10-6 right now over the Rumble. You on here at this beautiful location in New Jersey where the weather is absolutely gorgeous today here at John Bauer Memorial Stadium, campus of Randolph High School. As we just about minute 18 remaining till halftime, Tony, and the Spinners trying to pull away right now with a 10-6 advantage.
I'd like to see what they have set up. They've been playing a vertical stack all game. That's their game. And now they are in a horizontal 3-4. It's clearly a play call. They have plenty of time. Let's see if the Spinners can add another one. Now, Don, I wonder in the strategy here, do you want to score with leaving no time left on the clock? In other words, they want to milk a minute, or do they want a quick score? Well, they're going for the quick score. And that's going to work.
They want the goal, and they got it. Well done.
Throw from Schull. A little inside-out action. Beautiful. Put enough beautiful touch on that where it just sailed in there nicely.
Might have been Patrick Devaney on the receiving end if the name
right.
Equals the number.
I really love that throw from Schull there. He threw it to space. He had his man behind him, so he wasn't marked, so he can get that break mark, kind of an inside-out looping pass. And they went for the quick score. So gives New York now a minute, plenty of time to score. I wonder if they, too, will go for a quick score and maybe get a 2-for-1. I'm not sure. It's interesting how the strategy will play out with the timed game in effect. Timed games, Don, is interesting. For 40 years plus that we've been playing Ultimate, rarely have there been timed games, except for the very early years where they did play at a time. So this isn't something that's groundbreaking and changing the nature of the sport at all. This is something that has been, since its inception, part of the game.
So let's see what New York will do with that time factor now with the 107 remaining as they receive the disc.
Arrogant looking. Jody's all, Jody turfs that one, unfortunately. A little rusty out there. And a quick strike from Philadelphia has an opportunity. What a catch. Nice run. Another beautiful put there. Little lefty throw. Is that Nick Perfico with the disc score? I believe it looks like it.
Yeah, it looked like Perfico would make a nice play.
Yeah.
A perfect play for the score. And they up it to a 6-goal lead now. 6-point lead at 12-6 with 50 seconds remaining.
Now this is embarrassing now for New York. Let's see if they can regroup. But I got to say, Philly looks good. They're running hard. None of these guys look tired. And when they streak deep, they're getting the disc deep. It's good.
I think it's a confident team, too, from, of course, all that success from a year ago. And these guys know each other so well. You got a few new faces, of course, in the lineup. But overall, they've been solid.
Yeah. Oh, they're confident. They're going to be even, once Trey gets back out there, you'll see them even more confident, if that's possible.
Here comes the pull.
Well, they're really opening up here. You see Harrison with the pull, Trigu, which means he's on the D-line, and he's been on the O-line. We've seen him, so they're starting to mix it up on the spinner side as well, of course. Gillies. Heyman. Fakes the hammer. It's about the Gillies.
If I remember correctly, Heyman likes that hammer throw, doesn't he?
There's the easy score.
Yeah, Murphy to Heyman.
That's Avergan again.
So it makes it 12-7. Just want to mention with a quick break, found it just last year. The Ulti Apps application was designed to help teams and players track their performances on the club ultimate field now with a variety of updates and a new suite of applications. Ulti Apps is providing the power behind MLU's push for in-depth and accurate stats, statistics out there. Also be designing the MLU Fantasy Ultimate application that will be available to fans just before the season starts. Now visit ultiapps.com today for more information.
Don, I know that guy. I know the Ulti Apps guy.
You know the
Tushar
guy.
Tushar Singh is a good friend of mine. Congrats to Tushar for getting his. Don, we're going to try it out a little bit here. Let's see here. I have it on
you
my
got the
phone.
App? Beautiful.
Oh, game's back on. Okay, no time for playing around with this. Well, halftime, we're going to play around with the Ulti Apps.
There you go. What a beautiful day. One of the nicest day of the spring we've had, really. Fortunate to have terrific weather.
Seconds, Don. Is that going to stay in? Yes. Hearing that's looking. It's a zone. This could be a smart call. Ooh, the zone gets the turnover. Now they've got 6 seconds to score. Does Milo realize that? Snyder. He's got to throw this. 3-2. Oh, it could be a goal. Oh, beautiful. He gets up in time, makes
Did
the play.
Get it?
So Smash catches it.
I think they may wave it off here.
It looks
here.
Like a travel call.
I think that was the call. That pivot foot did slide.
So I hope we get to see it. Take a look at that. There's another call Vanny, the ref, is making. It looks like a travel on the thrower is a turnover. And that's what he's injured. The Rumble player is walking off.
I believe that's Winninger.
That is. They're going to try to put some time back on the clock. 14 minutes is not quite the time. I don't know. Did we see that? Did he move? He's hurt.
Well, he kind of slipped and fell forward. Pivot foot did move. I think it's a pretty good call by the officials.
Unfortunate because he's hurt, and that's how he ended up falling down. But that is the case. They put 9 seconds back on the clock, so Philly's going to have to huck it here, which they will. Here is the jack coming right here. He's got a spot there.
Will it fit in? Now it's going to be knocked away.
Slasko can't get to it. And New York makes the D to end the half.
Well, interesting first half. New York got out to the quick start. Philadelphia comes roaring back, and they'll take the halftime lead by 5 at 12-7. We'll keep it right here as we're going down the field side in just a moment, of course, and have a chat down below, which should be exciting. Looking forward to that, but the The Rumble and the Spinners here in this exhibition game, putting on quite a show for the folks, and should be exciting. Antoine Johnson is down below. Let's go down to Antoine.
Hey, and I'm back here with Trent Simmons, who is the national director for IUC. Tell me about IUC really quick.
IUC is the Indoor Ultimate Championships. We're in our inaugural season. We are having our national championship tournament today and tomorrow here in Randolph. And we're very excited to basically bring a new national championship series to the U.S.
Now, where do these teams come from? You have different regions, areas these teams come from. Where they come from?
Kind of all over the country. The furthest that came for this is Colorado, but also have teams from New England all the way down the Atlantic seaboard.
And if you're a spectator, what can you expect to see at a game like this?
Okay, well, the action is nonstop. We have subbing on the fly, and as soon as you score, you put the disc down, and the other team starts playing right away. So it's literally nonstop action.
A game of enduring strength and agility the whole nine. Are you excited about it?
Oh, so excited. Like, one of the things I'm most excited about is just watching the different styles clash. Because there's been indoor ultimate in the United States for a long time, but there's just so many different things. And that was one of our challenges. Was bringing all of the rules together. So what I can't wait to see is, does the run and gun style work better than the work it down? You know, how intense is the defense? Do you put on the full court press? Or do you sit back and protect the end zone?
Very nice. There we go. Good luck today, and hopefully we'll be able to talk a bit later about how the rest of the season's going to go and kind of get some more information.
All right.
Guys, back to you upstairs.
Yeah, thanks, MLU.
Yep. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, you bet.
The fans and...